All right, I'm going to walk through the basic steps of how to edit home videos taking on your camera. First, you got to take some videos, import them to your PC. I won't walk through that. I assume you know how to do that. And then we're going to use some video editing software and finally export the final video. Now, I suggest using Windows Movie Maker because it's simple and it's free. If you have Windows 7, this is where it's located. You go to the Start button. I have it pinned up to the top. You can go to All Programs, Movie Maker. You can also just look on the Microsoft website and download it. So it's free. First thing you do when you open it up is you need to add videos or photos. So you click the top button there. I have a folder called Canada with some pictures and some videos. I'm going to select the video. It says MP4. This is something I've imported off of my camera. And you can see now it's going to load on the right side the actual video. The left side is a big preview screen. When you do videos, you'll see this little clock. It takes a, depending on how large it is and how long, it takes some time. So you see the bottom left, there's kind of a little meter going on there. I'll show you when it's ready to do something. So while I'm waiting, I can even go get something else. I'm going to go get just a still digital photo. And you can see it puts it at the end. So I've added one, I add another, and it's going to keep adding 10. Now I can highlight those, grab it, and put it in the beginning. Now for just digital photos, it keeps them there for a length. It'll show the photo for 7 seconds by default. But if you double click, it'll take you to this edit menu at the top. You can see all these different tabs. Duration, I'm going to change it to 4 seconds, I guess. So it'll just show, if I hit play in the preview, it just holds it there for 4 seconds instead of the default 7. Okay, so my video is finally ready. So I've added a video, and I'm just going to go through a couple things. There's tons of options and little things you can do, but the most basic things you want to do is you want to organize it. In this case, I put a picture, and then I put some video. You can also see on the side, there's a down at the bottom right, there's a zoom in and zoom out. And I'm going to zoom it way out, which means I want that time table that of there to be much smaller. I don't need to see each second, so to speak. So now that bar there, I can just move along the timeline. And kind of a key thing you want to do is on the edit tab, there's split, start point, and end point. And this is how you can actually take out stuff you don't want. I'm going to do split, so that takes that whole video and it splits it right wherever my little marker was. Now this way I can now take the second half, I can go to a point in time and maybe I can just end it right there or I can start it right there. In this case, I'm just going to end it, so I've just shortened the video. I've just cut out all that stuff at the end. I'm going to add some more video. Actually, I'm going to add a picture at the end. Again, I'm going to double click on it. 5 seconds. And this is maybe all you really need to do. I'm going to save this. Now, this is saving the whole project. So the key difference is right now I just have a project where I've added some video, I've added some pictures. That video I trimmed, or the original, is still fine. That's the other key thing. Now I'm going to go in that home tab. I'm going to add a title. And I'm, call it O Canada. And this is just kind of the basics you may want for just a very basic home video. You can put a title. You're going to trim up some of the video, take out parts you don't want, and kind of organize it. You can see there's, fonts and sizes and stuff like that you can play around. So there's tons of options here. And the only other thing is when you did title, you can see it's going to kind of fade in. And up at the top right here are just some different options. You want to scroll from the bottom. Do you want these different motions to start with? So there's plenty of stuff to play with. That gives it a nice title. And the other thing I'll add here is if you go click into, in between each section, you may want some sort of transition. So if you go animation, you can see there's all these type of things where, different shapes and sizes. And so I'll do a couple of those. These are kind of the basics that you might want for a home video or highlight film or whatever. So I just pick some random ones. Again, this is adding all to the project. The original video has not changed, even though I've trimmed it up. You don't need to do a save as or anything. This is just all within this project here. Yeah, Movie Maker. right? So I'm kind of adding another transition at the end. And you, again, you can see the preview on the left. And I'm going to save it, save the project again. So I've had all those changes. Now, when I'm finally done, the key thing is this is not done. I can't just go watch this. So I'm going to go to save movie. And I'm going to give it a name. And this is where I'm basically going to compile this together into one file. You know, it was one video, edited and two pictures, and now I'm going to compile it into one video. So that save as, that save file, I chose to the high def. There's other options and based on how big you want it for YouTube and different things like that. And when it's all done, I can open, close, or play the folder. You can see I have some other stuff kind of around there. And you can see there's my final MP4 file. There's the project. There's the final version of the video. And you can open it up in Media Player. You could put it up on YouTube and all that type of stuff. And just for kicks, I just added the final product at the end of this video. You can watch just to see what I've done. So hope this helps, and good luck.